Discussion on left ventricular hypertrophy on echocardiogram. Parasternal long axis view showing concentric left ventricular hypertrophy. Both interventricular septum and left ventricular posterior wall are thickened significantly. Please subscribe to this channel for future updates. Click on the subscribe button. Press the bell icon after that for all updates. Parasternal short axis view at the level of the papillary muscles showing severe concentric left ventricular hypertrophy. Serial short axis views have to be obtained and maximal thickness documented when assessing hypertrophic cardiomyopathy for risk profile. M-mode echocardiogram showing left ventricular hypertrophy. IVSD, interventricular septum diastolic measurement. LVIDD, left ventricular internal dimension diastolic. LVPWD, left ventricular posterior wall diastolic. IVSS, interventricular septum systolic. LVIDS, interventricular septum systolic. LVPWS, left ventricular posterior wall systolic. EDV, end diastolic volume. FS, fractional shortening. ESV, end systolic volume. SV, stroke volume. EF, ejection fraction. Apical four-chamber view showing left ventricular hypertrophy. Left atrium seems to be a bit dilated, probably secondary to LV diastolic dysfunction in LVH. Another case showing left ventricular hypertrophy with dysfunction on M-mode echocardiogram. M-mode echocardiogram showing gross left ventricular hypertrophy and moderate to severe left ventricular systolic dysfunction. Inset shows short axis view of the left ventricle demonstrating severe concentric LVH. Left ventricular systolic dysfunction occurs in late stage of hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. In the initial stages, there is only left ventricular diastolic dysfunction due to the grossly thickened ventricular myocardium with poor diastolic relaxation. In late stages, chronic overload can cause failure of the left ventricular myocardium with systolic dysfunction. In this stage, there can be progressive dilatation of the left ventricular cavity. A similar echocardiographic pattern of severe LVH with LV systolic dysfunction can also occur when severe aortic stenosis goes in for LV systolic dysfunction and heart failure. Same can occur in coarctation of aorta with heart failure and severe systemic hypertension with left ventricular systolic dysfunction. Thickened left ventricular myocardium with systolic dysfunction can also occur in cardiac amyloidosis. Here is a journal reference on detection of LVH by M-mode echocardiography. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.